This episode is sponsored by Endel, an app that creates personalized soundscapes to help you focus, relax, and sleep. The first 100 people to click our link in the description will get a 1 week free trial. Depending on your love of horror stories or your belief in the supernatural, it might be easy to convince you that lakes are full of ghosts. That as you plunge deeper into these lakes' depths, you will come across translucent bodies that come alive when nighttime sets in. What you might not expect, however, is that the ghosts look like this. An elongated body with its limbs all packed close to the head, wrenching open and closed like scissors that propel our spectral friend in jarring motions. This is Lepidodora, a genus of water flea whose transparent bodies have inspired many of the researchers who study them to call them ghost fleas. Lepidodora are cladocerans, the more scientific name given to water fleas, and cladocerans are micro-sized members of the crustacean family, making the ghost flea a distant, approximately centimeter-length relative of the much less spooky lobsters and shrimp. The Lepidodora is more closely related to Daphnia, a creature who we've come across before on our journey through the microcosmos. And for Daphnia, the Lepidodora family relation is kind of an unfortunate one because, frankly, Lepidodora don't care about it. They have more important things to focus on, like, for example, eating Daphnia. So if you're trying to hunt down the ghost flea, the key is to look for lakes that are full of plankton-eating fish, because those lakes tend to be full of planktonic cladocerans, like Daphnia. For James, our master of microscopes, there is a specific lake in Warsaw that seems to meet the criteria, and that has reliably turned up Lepidodora. But even when he is able to track them down and watch them under the microscope, it can be difficult for him to maintain them in his own home. They seem to be particularly sensitive to the conditions of the water they live in, but unfortunately, we don't know exactly what it is that they are sensitive to. So we're lucky to be able to see the ones that we can. Now, despite its transparent body, there is one feature of the Lepidodora that clearly stands out. The single cyclops eye that wobbles at the front end of the flea, attached to a tube that extends into the Lepidodora's body. When you zoom in, you can see slices that look like thin petals projecting out from the center of the eye. There are around 500 of these slices, and they are each a crystalline cone structure called an ommatidium. Within each ommatidium are 5 cells that help the Lepidodora see. But just as important is what the ommatidium doesn't have. The edges are lacking pigments, which helps the Lepidodora stay more transparent to avoid detection by predators. This eye helps the Lepidodora move in response to the light around it, and it may even help the flea find areas with food. But interestingly, when a group of researchers studied the Lepidodora's hunting habits in 1989, they found that sometimes the Lepidodora would be swimming and swimming in search of food, only to swim right past a perfectly good meal, as if they couldn't see it. And other times, they describe the Lepidodora attacking random bits of debris or empty cladocerin carapaces, again, as if they could not see what they were targeting. And what that suggested to the researchers is that perhaps the ghost flea doesn't use its eye to hunt. Instead, it seems to be a primarily tactile hunter, using its own body like a bear trap that springs into action upon the slightest touch. The Lepidodora's thoracic legs surround its mouth, creating a sort of trap or basket for its food. And in fact, this structure has names like feeding basket or trap basket to describe its purpose so very precisely. Lepidodora spend the daytime at the bottom of their lakes, hiding out in the low oxygen areas that keep them safe from fish that want to eat them. And during the nighttime, the Lepidodora will rise to the surface, deploying its trap basket body in the process. As it swims through the waters and prey brushes up against them, the Leptodora's body responds on instinct, pulling its abdomen forward and grabbing its legs around its new meal like a very, very dangerous hug. And from there, the Leptodora uses its mandibles to dig the tissue out of its prey and consume it, disposing of the unwanted bits of carapace that surround their meal the way that we might discard a shrimp tail. In some instances, researchers have also observed male Leptodora using their longer antennae, which are much shorter in females, to sweep food into their feeding basket. This is both a practical use of antenna and a very interesting observation because for most of the year, male Leptodora don't actually exist. You could say that they are the most ghostly ghost flea of all. For most of the year, Leptodora reproduce parthenogenetically, which means that they simply lay their eggs without relying on any other fertilization. The female Leptodora's brood chamber fills with yellowish eggs that are produced asexually, and eventually, those eggs will hatch into larvae inside the Leptodora. And for most of the year, those hatched Leptodora will be female. But in the fall, male Leptodora begin to appear. Their main function is to allow for sexual reproduction, which gives the ghost flea a chance to mix its genes and produce a more diverse population. And the eggs that result from sexual reproduction are different from the parthenogenetic eggs. Instead of being kept in the Leptodora herself, these transparent eggs, called resting eggs, are released into the water, where they will eventually sink to the bottom of the lake. And the eggs remain until one day they hatch a new ghost to haunt its lake. Thank you for coming on this journey with us as we explore the unseen world that surrounds us. And thank you to Endel for sponsoring this episode. Endel is an app that takes everything we know about sound, combines it with technology, and creates personalized soundscapes to help you focus, relax, and sleep. Their app was named the Apple Watch App of the Year in 2020, and they have a brand new soundscape called Wind Down that they made in collaboration with James Blake. The goal of Wind Down is to help you transition from an active day to a calmer state, so it is great just before bed too. Sound has a direct impact on your physical and mental well-being, and by adapting in real time to things like your location, weather, and heart rate, Endel creates simple, pleasant sounds that can help to calm your mind. If you're interested in trying out Endel, just be one of the first 100 people to download it using the link in our description, and you will get a free week of audio experiences. The folks whose names are on the screen right now, they are our Patreon patrons, without whom we definitely and completely could not make this lovely little YouTube show that hopefully you enjoy. So if you want to be thankful that cool things get to exist, join me in being thankful to them. If you want to see more from our Master of Microscopes, James Weiss, you can check out Jam and Germs on Instagram. And if you want to see more from us, there's always a subscribe button somewhere nearby. Thank you.